Welcome to my channel. That's English with Palaisa. I hope you will safe at home. Today I am going to discuss a very interesting grammar, that is direct speech and indirect speech. Before teaching it, you know what do you mean by direct speech and indirect speech. You may report the actual words of a speaker in two ways. That is direct way and another indirect way. What do you mean by direct way? You may quote the actual words of a speaker, it's called direct. Again, indirect, when you express or report the actual words what he said without quoting, that is indirect way. Look at the example. This is the direct speech, this is the indirect speech. There is a clause, comma, and there is a full clause, full stop, question, and exclamation within inverted comma. Again, in their speech, two clauses are connected that no comma is here, at the end, the full stop. This part is the reporting verb, this part is the reported speech. Okay? Look at the example. Rajesh said, I am ill today. Here is a reporting verb separated by comma. Then the beginning of the reported speech is a capital letter. Then full stop within inverted comma. But when you change in direct speech, look at this. Rajesh said that we are connected by two clauses. Then you come. I change into he because I refers to Rajesh. He was, am refers to was, the tense is here changed. Then ill, today change into that day. Okay. I would like to say here the actual words of Rajesh is I am ill today. Okay. But in direct speech, Rajesh said that he was ill that day. That means Rajesh does not speak it. But this indirect speech is reported by because. The another person, by another person. You know that the politicians speak dialogues. Reported by the reporter to the newspaper. Okay, that means Rajesh's actual words is reported by Vikas. What Rajesh said? Now I am ill today. But what Vikas said? Rajesh said that he was ill that day. This is the indirect speech. Okay, let us look at the example now. No, you have to follow some certain rules so that the Britishers speak their language fluently. So, how many changes are here? First pronoun, then tense, then time, and places. So, they have a vital role in direct speech. Let us discuss by one. First, we discuss the pronoun. You know, persons are divided into three parts. That is, first person, second person, and third person. Let us discuss according to the its verb, object form, and possessive form. Look at the screen. First person, I, subject, object, me, possessive, mine. We, the subject, object form, us, possessive form, our. Third, second person, you, your. Third person, he, him, his. She, her. They, them, their. It, its. Boys, them, they are. For example, Sonu says, I am a cricket player. In their speech, Sonu says that he is a cricket player. Here, I pronoun is Sonu. So that, Sonu says that he is a cricket player. As the reporting verb is present, so that the reported speech must be present. there is no change at all. Then full stop. Another example, Sonu says to me, you are a football player. Look at this. Sonu tells me that I am a football player. Me changing here, me is equal to you. That means you change into according to me. So in indirect speech, the person is changed, I. Sonu tells me what? Sonu tells me that I am a football player. Here note that says to change into tells. Like that, said to change into told. You remember it. Note another note is here. Direct speech. When you see that reporting verb is present, the reported speech must be in present. Look at another example. Discuss the present tense. Okay, look at the screen. Sachin said, I am a good batsman. In the Indian speech, Sachin said that he was a good batsman. What is the change here? I refers to Sachin. I is a pronoun. Subject is Sachin. So that Sachin said that he was a good batsman. The reported speech is present, but the reporting verb is past. So that the reported speech changes into past in indirect speech. Another example, Sachin said to me, you do not play cricket. Answer, Sachin told me that I did not play cricket. Me is equal to you. That means I. Sachin told me that I did not play cricket. Present change into past, then said to change into me. Okay. Another example, look at the screen. Sachin said to Dhoni, you are not playing well now. Here, you is equal to Dhoni. Look at the example. Sachin told Dhoni that he was not playing well. You change into he because the objective pronoun is Dhoni. Okay, another example. Vikas said to me, you have not given my book today. Here, look at, Vikas told me that I had not given his book that day. What is the change here? My book, that means his book. And today change into that day. And you change into me, according to me. So that the Vikas told me that I had not given his book that day. Okay, another example. She said, I have been writing for you. In that speech, she said that she had been writing for me. You change into me in Indian speech. But what is the most important point is here? Report, when you get reporting verb in past, the reported speech must be changed into past. Remember, some certain rules, what to be changed, what not to be changed. Okay? Look at change of adverbials in indirect speech. Direct, now changing to then or at that time, today, that day, yesterday, the day before, or the following day, the day before, yesterday, 2 days before, tomorrow, the next day, or the following day, this week, that way, a year changing to a year before, or discuss the present tense. Okay, look at the screen. Tenses are changed. Look at the rules of the tense. In indirect speech, the simple present change into past simple indirect, present progressive change into past progressive, present perfect change into past perfect, present perfect progressive change into past perfect progressive. But past simple change into past perfect, past progressive change into past perfect progressive. It is very important. Perfect or past perfect progressive, no change at all. Remember. Now, let us discuss modal auxiliaries change into indirect speech. Okay. Will change into would, shall change into should or would, can change into could, may, might, must or have to or would have to. Remember it. Okay, look at the example now. He said to me, you will go home. In Indian speech, he told me they would go home. Here we change into they. Said to change into told. In another example, Silu said, I must go soon. In Indian speech, Silu said that she would have to go soon. That is future. Here, that is option. Here, that is optional. Okay. There is another example. He said, I must go there. In Indian speech, he said, he had to go there. That is necessity. That is usually left out in conversation and in informal writing. Okay, remember it. Lucy said, I posted the letter yesterday. In that speech, Lucy said that she had posted the letter the previous day. What is the changes here? It is past simple. I refers to Lucy. Lucy is a lady. So that she had posted, that is simple past change into past perfect. The letter yesterday changed into the previous day. I said, I was working 10 hours a day. In Indian speech, Lisa said that she had been working 10 hours a day. What are the changes here? I refers to Lisa. There is no problem here. Lisa said that she had been working 10 hours a day. Okay. Another example. He said, I had helped my friend a lot before. He said, I had helped my friends a lot before. In Indian speech, he said that he had helped his friends a lot before. There is no change because it is a past perfect. Another example, Sonu said, I had been doing my homework in the morning. In that speech, Sonu said that he had been doing his work in the morning. I would like to say some certain rules. If the statement expresses a universal truth or a habitual action or a historical event, the tense in reported speech does not change in indirect speech. You have to remember it. Now, look at the screen. Sun rises in the east. In Indian speech, he said that the sun rises in the east. It is universal truth or general truth, you may say. No changes at all, only connected by that. And ending, full stop. Okay. Then, Sipun said, oil floats on water. It is scientific truth. Sipun said that oil floats on water. No changes at all here. Okay. Another example here. Chinu said, I get up early in the morning. It is a habitual action, you know. Chinu said that she gets up early in the morning. Only pronoun changed. Okay. Another example. Mr. Pillai said, India became independent in 1947. It is a historical event. In Indian speech, Mr. Pillai said that India became independent in 1947. No changes, only that is used here. Okay, another example. Mita said, if I were a bird, I would fly in the sky. You know, it is a clause. It is a time adverb clause. In Indian speech, Mita said that if she were a bird, she would fly in the sky. Only pronoun is changed here or nothing is changed. Thank you very much for watching this video. Don't forget to watch the second part of this topic video. Okay, if you have any doubt, please comment me. I would like to help you.